Today in this session, we want to study random variable. Learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of random variables. The contents of these topics are, first we see what is the means of random variable, then we study types of random variable. There are two types, one is a discrete random variable and second one is continuous random variable. We want to see in details. First, random variables. A random variable is a variable that assumes numerical values associated with random outcomes of an experiment where one and only one numerical value is assigned to each sample point. Means here for the each sample point only one value we can assign and we get the output that is called as random variable. A random variable, there is a property how we denoted that random variables. There are some properties we can assume here. A random variable is denoted with a capital letter. The probability distribution of a random variable X tells what the possible values of X are and how probabilities are assigned to those values. A random variable can be discrete or continuous. Types of random variables. There are basically two types of random variables. First, discrete random variables. Second, continuous random variable. Now we study in detail one by one. That first we want to study here discrete random variable. Discrete random variable. A discrete variable is a variable whose value is obtained by counting. For example, for the discrete random variables are number of students present in the class, number of red marbles in a jar, number of heads when flipping the three coins, students grade level. If you observe these examples, we get here one numerical value, only one numerical value, that is a property of random variable. And the discrete random variable means what? We get variable whose value is obtained by counting. For example, student present, red marbles, flipping the three coins, students grade level, we can obtain by counting. That's why these are the examples of discrete random variable. Now, problems on this discrete random variable. A pair of fair dice is rolled. Let X denote the sum of the number of dots on the top faces. Then calculate, construct the probability distribution of X. Second, find probability X greater than or equal to 9. Third, find the probability that X takes an even value. Now we solve the first one, that is construct the probability distribution of X. Now here we observe the possible outcomes of this event is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Means what? There are how many dice are there? Two dice. One die shows one, second die shows there is a possibility of one. Second one, 1, 2. Third one, 1, 3. 1, 4. In this way, same. First one, now the second event, it will shows the 2. Second one, 1. In this way, 2, 1. 2, 2. 2, 3. 2, 4. 2, 5. 2, 6. Means in this way, we get 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6. In this way, we get these possible outcomes. The possible values for X are the numbers 2 through 12. X equal to 2 is the event 11, 1, 1. So P of 2 is equal to what? 1 by 36. Means what here? Total possibility is how much? 36. Therefore, add the event 2. The event 2 means what? 1 by 36. We apply here the basic definition of probability. That is, probability is equal to number of events divided by number of samples. Here, how many number of samples? 36. And how many number of events? That's a 2 comes. 1 plus 1. That is a 1. 1 by 36. Now, for the same, here we apply X equal to 3. Means what? X equal to 3 means what? Sum. We want to get the sum X equal to 3 when we get 1, 2 and 2, 1. Therefore, number of events are there, how much? 2. And number of samples, 36. Therefore, apply the basic definition of probability here. Probability of 3 is equal to 2 by 36. Therefore, for each event, here in the table we calculated, that is X event and respective for that one probability. Apply the basic definitions and we got this one. For the X equal to 2, we get probability of X equal to 1 by 36. For 3, it will 2 by 36. 4, 3 by 36. 5, 4 by 36. For the 6, 5 by 36. For 7, 6 by 36. For 8, 5 by 36. For 9, 4 by 36. For 10, 3 by 36. For 11, 2 by 36. And for 12, it is a 1 by 36. This is the solution for first. Now, second, What is the second question? The event x greater than equal to 9 is the union of the mutual exclusive events of x equal to 9, x equal to 10, x equal to 11 and x equal to 12. Why you are getting up to here 12 only? Because the maximum outcome of this first one and second one is 6. Their sum is what? 6 plus 6 is 12. Now what we want to obtain? Probability x greater than equal to 9. Then what is the probability for the solution? Is probability of 9 plus probability of 10 plus probability of 11 plus probability of 12. Therefore, it will become as 0.27 and it will obey the property, yes, that is less than 1. Now, third one, the probability that x takes an 6 different even values. That 6 different even values means what? The out of this probability samples, we can take an even values. Which one? That one? Probability of 2, probability of 4, probability of 6, probability of 8, probability of 10 and probability of 12. And we can write basic definitions of, and from that table, probability of 2 is what? 1 by 36, probability of 4 is 3 by 36. Probability of 6 is 5 by 36, probability of 8 is 5 by 36 and probability of 10 is 3 by 36 and probability of 12 is 1 by 36. Therefore, it will become as a 0.5 and it will obey the property. Yes, it will be less than 1. Now, the diagram, we can draw the diagram from this equation, that is a probability distribution of x. Now, probability, this diagram shows probability versus outcome. Now probability shows is the y-axis and outcome shows is the x-axis. Now we draw these graphs and this graph shows the probability distribution of a discrete random variable. Now here if you observe, the probability is always less than 1 and starting from the 0, that is 0, 0.05, 0.10, 0.15 and 0.20, and respective outcomes we can draw this diagram, and this diagram is related to the probability distribution of a discrete random variable. Now continuous random variable. A continuous variable is a variable whose value is obtained by measuring, for example, height of a student in a class, weight of a student in a class, time it takes to get to school, distance traveled between the classes. These are the continuous random variables. Example, this is obtained by measuring, and for the continuous random variable, we can by counting. Now, this equation for a continuous random variable with probability density function f of x, this is the equation f of x into d of x equal to 1, that is all the x values range. Now we want to study the example of a continuous random variable. What is that continuous random variable? X is a continuous random variable with probability density function is given by function f of x equal to c of x, and the range of for x is 0 less than x less than equal to 1, where c is a constant, find c. Now friends, before going to the continuous random variable, always remember the continuous random variable we calculate with the help of the integration. Here we take the each value. For the discrete random variable, we take only countable value, but for the continuous random variable, we can take the values from the range. That's why here we use the integration. Now here recall the continuous distribution function formula. Now continuous distribution function formula is integration of f of x into d of x equal to 1, and that f of x is all the x range. Now put the values. What is f of x? F of x equal to c of x into d of x equal to 1, and what is the range of that integration? It will lies between 0 to 1, and see everyone observe that one and give that one range 0 to 1 and put the value of c of x into d of x equal to 1, then what we get? The value of c. Now you know that right hand side, see, we want to calculate here value of c. You know the they are given the 0 to 1, that is a x value, and right hand side we know that is a 1, and can you find out from that one value of the c? Yes, we find out that from value of c. What is that one? C. Here put the values, range. What is the range? Range of f of x into d of x equal to 0 to 1, that we here apply here 0 to 1, and put the value of f of x equal to what? C of x into d of x, and what is equal to 1. Therefore c of x integration after the doing the integration, we get c by 2 is equal to 1, that is c is equal to 2. Now references for these topics are